was a drunkard and a shampoo user. And what would you do if you discover that your spouse is having an illicit affair, not just with one, but with three other women? How would you react if your spouse aims a gun at you and your children? I have experienced all these with my husband, and I suffered a miserable life for 10 long years. I'm sure it would be easy for you to decide to just leave the marriage and file for an annulment, thinking that there is no more reason for staying. All of these may be too much to bear, but I realized that they were consequences of my wrong decisions early in life. I disobeyed my parents for having a relationship at a very early age, which led to my teenage pregnancy. I grew up with absentee parents who were both busy with their careers. My parents thought that providing us with material things could make up for their lost time, but they did not know that though I was the quiet, uncomplaining, easy-to-please daughter, I was actually longing for love. Until our neighbor, who was my greatest crush, eventually became my boyfriend when we were both 13. Yes, 13 years old. Medyo maaga. My parents got the greatest shock and scare of their lives when they found out that I was already 6 months pregnant and I was only 18 then. My parents did not like my boyfriend, so they decided to allow us to live together. Marriage will come later, thinking that we were both immature. We were both undergraduates, so we had no work, and we depended on my in-laws for our basic needs, even that of my baby's needs after I gave birth. I thought my partner would somehow look for a job to fend for our basic necessities, but he ended up getting hooked with shabu. He spent more time with his friends, and he would usually go home the following morning. There would be nights when I would be surprised with several problems, such as a call from the hospital because of a major car accident, of which he had two, or from physical injuries because of fist fights, sometimes even with policemen or the military. He was detained several times in different police stations for cases of robbery and physical injuries, and he also got involved in murder and gang rape, all at the age of 17. No amount of tears can make my husband change. Every day I would wait, cry, and pray. I even had Bible studies from a cult for 2 years, but I felt something was lacking. I knew in my heart that it was only God that I can run to, but then I was constantly seeking and longing for peace. In 1995, I was invited by my sister-in-law to attend a worship service at CCM Valle Verde because she was going to give her testimony. Shortly after arriving, I found myself singing praise songs to God, and I couldn't stop myself from crying. At the end of the speaker's message, I made the most wonderful decision in my life, and that was to accept Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior. Suddenly, there was peace, joy, and so much love in my heart. And with all the problems that I was going through in my marriage, I realized that God was the only solution to my problem. We got married in a Christian wedding through CCF after 5 years of living together, but he never changed. In fact, the night before the wedding, my husband admitted that he got involved with my neighbor, who happens to be my kumarin and a friend, and then a best friend of my closest cousin, and several other women, most of which were live-in relationships. So parang si kumarin, who happens to be our neighbor, we would really meet in her house. And then pag medyo gumagabi na, my husband would tell me, uwi ka na kasi late na. So, hahatid niya ako sa bahay, and then babalik siya kay kumare. Tapos sila ni kumare for like, more than a year. And then there's this other friend of ours na, so my husband and I fought, and then nag-ari kami, and then my husband slapped me on the cheeks. Tapos umawat tong friend namin, yung pala, kalipin siya ng asawa ko nang mahigit isang taon. So, you know, these were relationships that he would admit to me after it was through because there was another one. So, ganun yung naging routine. And some of them were really women I knew. It was easy finding out if he had a girlfriend, but it would be very hard to make him admit. He would usually confess about his relationships after they were through. But among all the relationships he had, the last one was, there was this relationship that he had, which was really the most painful. Why? You know, when I, you know, discovered about it, you know, I asked my husband, sabi ko sa kanya, are you in a relationship with this Michelle? Meron pong Michelle dito? Wala? Usually, palaging may Michelle pag may tinatanong ako. So anyway, my husband had two Michelles in his life. And then I asked him, so are you involved with this Michelle? And you know, my husband said, yeah. So sabi ko, wow, for the first time he admitted. So, but the difference is that with this one, he immediately, he gave a follow-up question. He said, okay lang ba sa'yong iwanan ko siya? So ako naman, parang I was thinking, maybe just like the other relationships in the past, this too will come to an end. So I said, sige, aantayin ko. Okay, so I agreed. I even befriended the girl, hoping that she and my husband would have pity on me. I would ask the girl each time. So there were, it went on for several months and I would call the girl. Kasi I don't have to ask my husband eh. Kasi alam ko na kung sino, diba? So I stopped asking, are you, sino kasama mo? Eh, alam ko na kung sino kasama niya. So when I would call her, I would ask her, you know, hindi umuwi yung asawa ko ng gabi, hindi umuwi yung asawa ko ng 3 days, hindi umuwi yung asawa ko ng 1 week. Magkasama ba kayo? And she would say, oo, nagpunta kami sa ganito, sa ganyan. So she would really tell me stories and I would listen to her. But hindi ko siya inaaway. It went on for months. And, you know, I only stopped when I realized that, you know, my husband was really in love with her. So I stopped calling her. And, you know, but personally, because it was really becoming more painful, you know, hearing those stories, it was really becoming very hard to bear. It was during the 1 year period of tolerating the affair that he would say, I love you, to his mistress on the cell phone while I was beside him, but I just kept quiet and cried silently. So, just to tell you that story, like, the one if you're inside the car, you would hear, if someone's on the phone and then you're beside that person, you will hear the voice of somebody on the receiver. So, I heard a girl say, katabi mo ba? Sabi niya, katabi mo ba? And then my husband said, oh, katabi ko. Gumugulong naman siya. Medyo nahihiya siya sa akin. So, and then the girl said, gusto ko sabihin mo, I love you. And then my husband said, pabulong. But of course, it was, you know, very clear pa din. And then, then the girl said, gusto ko sabihin mo mas malakas. And then my husband said, I love you. Nang mas malakas. And then it did not stop there. Because the girl said, gusto ko mas malakas pa. And then true enough, my husband did say, I love you the loudest. You know, if you ask me, it was really very painful. And it was really something very hard to bear. But what I would do is, of course, that time I can remember I was really crying nonstop, but silently. And I can't show my face to my husband because tears really can't stop falling. But what I did was, so I would be able to endure the pain, is that, you know, I would sing the song, God Will Make a Way. Do you know that song? Diba? The song goes, God will make a way when there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. So I said, Lord, this is so painful, but I know you will make a way. So every time I would remember that, how every time my husband would be talking to the girl and I would listen each time, I would, you know, keep it to myself. But I would sing that song each time because I know God will make a way. Pictures of the girl would be seen on his cell phone. In the past, call and text lang. But you know, my husband is very creative. photos on the back of his phone is the picture, is the sticker of the girl. So every time he uses his phone, I would see the picture of the girl. But, you know, I think that I came to know the Lord that I never removed it or threw it to his face, or I never told him, tanggalin mo naman yan, or, you know, don't use it, something like that. I can see it, but I did not do anything. I can see the pictures of the girl in his wallet, his organizer, and even inside the car. I saw the girl's passport. And a lot of things, my shorts, my whatever, which were not mine. But I never thought of removing or throwing any of them. My husband would even answer for calls while I was sneak hearing my husband say, I love you, I miss you, and sometimes even with matching kisses. I would pretend as if I did not hear anything. I just kept quiet and mastered the act of crying silently. My husband would even call me sweetheart when we call each other baby. I would find out from our friends and from my in-laws that my husband wanted to file for an annulment so that he can get married with his mistress. I was so devastated, but I decided to share my problems with my small group and chose to keep it from my parents and friends, thinking that I still wanted to protect my husband and our family. When my parents and close friends found out after 1 year that my husband left me for another woman, they convinced me to file for an annulment, which gave me so much pressure that I almost gave in. But whenever I go to God in His Word, I am reminded about His many promises in the Bible that gave me so much comfort and trust in God that with Him nothing is impossible. While my husband was enjoying his life with his mistress, I was enjoying mine with God. So I made myself busy with knowing the Lord more and more until I became so in love with God. It was my love for God that gave an unconditional love for my husband. And it was God's forgiveness of my sins that I also learned to forgive the sins of my husband. So I chose to live my life God's way and not my way. Then I realized that I was still the lawful wife. So I continued to submit to my husband and continued to serve him. There was no bitterness in my heart, no anger, no hatred. It is only by God's grace that I held on to my marriage. I never gave up. I prayed fervently, I waited patiently, and I surrendered wholeheartedly. And I was very hopeful of God's restoration of my marriage. And God was truly faithful in keeping His promises because He made miracles after miracles after miracles. My small group had been praying that the mistress would find someone who's single and that she and my husband would fall out of love for one another. And guess what? My husband's mistress got pregnant 2 times. But all became miscarriages. Soon after, I found out from our friends that their relationship had been turning sour. And then surprisingly, I found out that she later got married with a foreigner who was single. So after 3 years of separation with my husband, God did not only restore our marriage, He changed my husband to more than what I actually prayed for. My husband encountered a major trial when he was charged with a case of frustrated homicide. During the most miserable stage in his life, he remembered me, so he called me, and I fetched him right away. This became an opportunity for us to be together. I treated him as if he did not do anything for the past 3 years we were separated. I never mentioned about all his sins and the hurts he has given me. I killed him with kindness. There were times when I would notice him to be so quiet. Be so quiet and lonely. So I asked him if it's because he misses his mistress. And guess what was his answer? He gave an honest yes. But God never gave up on him, and so did I. Not long after, he started joining me in my Bible studies, then in the Sunday worship services at CCF, and then in the Dawn Watch. It was in the Dawn Watch the Holy Spirit really touched his heart and humbled him. It was the first time I saw him pray from the heart. You know, when that Don't Watch Day, I remember after the pastor gave a message,